Hey, what's up, everybody? Duke of the Bump here. I just got back from doing a little bit of shopping in Elfland. All they had were cherries and oranges, so I got some cherries, even though they suck. And I got a couple of chests that I missed the first time around. Oh, great. It's the Wood Golem. Now, this is yet another boss that's entirely about knowing where to stand. In this case, the place that you want to stand is directly in front of his fists. No. It's right here. So when he shoots his fist, theoretically, you just pop down and voila. And he never goes past a certain point. Once he scoots up far enough, he rockets backwards again. And you have time to fill up your ammo, your arms. Sorry about the weird encoding errors in the last video. There were some video glitches and the sound got desynchronized at some point. I'm not sure what happened with that. Oh, he's not dead though. He is not dead at all. Because once that happens, his head becomes detached, and you have to scramble like mad to try to hit it. I hit it for 5 points of damage. Oh, Christ. And he's back with full hit points again. Yeah, the orange sucks. That was in that's what was in the one chest that I fell and bounced off the screen and couldn't get. Lovely. I really should have saved before I started doing this, but oh well. I hate this boss. This is by far my least favorite boss in this game. Just because it's so annoying. I mean, you think you kill him, and then suddenly you have this tiny bouncing target that's impossible to hit. And it just takes forever. I'm probably going to spend this whole video trying to kill this son of a bitch. Okay, his head's going to fall. And it went the other way this time. Crap. It's nearly impossible to hit it, but it's really easy for it to hit you. Oh boy, you better believe it is. We got it down to 70. Let's use an apple and a cherry. That should bring me back up to full capacity. I guess there's really no point in saving again. But I mean, since I have full health, maybe if I need to load my game, it'll start me with full health. I don't know. So what actually happened was, for some reason, my save got deleted. I think it's because the power went off while I had my emulator open. Because I usually don't close the emulator between recording. I just minimize it and I come back to it later. Makes it a little easier to pick up exactly where I left off, since the emulator doesn't support save states for Sega CD. Shit. So yeah, I lost my save, and I ended up having to do everything I've done so far again. But it was okay, because I just turned the voices off, so I could just blaze right through the cutscenes. It made it a lot easier. I didn't see what I got him down to this time. Well, I hope I'm able to incapacitate him. By which I mean destroy him. It. The golem. If it's a golem, does that mean it's Jewish? Is that like an automatic thing? Or are there non-Jewish golems? I don't know, I don't see any writing on his head. I think it's a different kind of golem. There was an optional boss that I was going to try to fight. I never tried to fight it before, but a viewer told me about it back in Elftown. And I tried to fight him, and it was very difficult. I wasn't able to beat him with the equipment that I have now. I'm hoping that he stays there a while, so I can go back later and try to beat him again with better equipment. Because I was only doing 2 points of damage to him per hit. I better bulk up a little more here, because I know this thing's going to freaking hit me. Okay, got him down to 40. Not bad. Oh, come on. It's like trying to hit a flea with a BB gun.
Okay, should be able to do this. One more solid round of damage. Should take him out. But yeah, if you go back to that empty room in Elftown that I wondered about the first time around, if you go back to that again, once you talk to the lady in Tree Sun, then you can try to defeat the leader of the badger gang. Who's a big, fat, mean badger who summoned lots of tiny, mean badgers. And, like I said, I was only doing 2 points of damage to him every time I hit him. So, I'm going to try going back later. If you'll let me. I'm not sure what you would get from doing that optional quest.
I don't know, it might be good. Okay. Alright, got him. And I only had to eat 4 cherries, 2 apples, banana, and a donut.
What? She beat my wood golem? Impossible!
What?
What?
It sounded like the voice was coming from here.
No matter. This is but a small crimp in my plan.
Holy freaky creeps! I can't believe it! It is! It's Muttonhead!
In the flesh, sweet cakes! I'm the most powerful wizard ever! I'm the scourge of the land!
I still can't believe it's you!
I am the great and powerful Muttonhead!
Tat said you were outrageous. Boy, he wasn't kidding!
Oh, so you know Tato, eh? Well, that student was a pain in my patootie from day one. Always so goody too soon. But, I hear that he's cooling his heels in jail at the moment.
Which is precisely where you'll be after I haul you in. Ooh, I can hardly wait to collect that 2 mil for your ugly hide. Game's up, Muttonhead.
You capture me? You're a riot, kid. See you around.
Holy freaky creeps. Alright, let's go see what that blue-haired freak's up to. And it was around here somewhere. I better, put the save on this baby. Should be able to find him before I'm out of time here. Oh, there he is.
Ma'am, it's you! Oh, I thought I was to be trapped here forever. Quick, pull that lever on your left. It opens the cell door.
You haven't seen Muttonhead lately. Have you?
Quiet! We don't have time for that. Just pull the lever and let's get out of here.
I've got all the time in the world. So fess up. Have you seen him or not?
Mayo! Let me out of here and I'll tell you what I know about my teacher's location. Fair enough?
Okay. But remember, you promised. Now then, Junior. Where's Muttonhead?
I don't know for sure, but I think he's probably in his hideout in the Wind Cave. I'll take you there, but I have to warn you, it's really quite dangerous. That's it, Male. The dreaded Wind Cave, one of the most dangerous places in the land, just crawling with monsters.
Tat, I'm not afraid. It'll be a great test of my fighting skill.
We must be very cautious, Male. Muttonhead is no ordinary magician.
I know he's hiding in there. I can feel him. And when I find him, he's all mine. Then I can collect that big fat reward! No time to lose. Let's go!
Alright, I'm going to have to edit this a little bit to make it fit, but that does it for this edition of Let's Play Popful Mail. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.